Hey, McGeek, who sent Ziva the flowers?
Jealous.
Jealous? Me? No, of course not.
You sure? Because you sound jealous.
I'm just surprised someone would send Ziva flowers. That's all.
Why are you surprised?
Yeah, what girl doesn't like getting flowers?
Girls, yes, but we're talking about Ziva.
Grab your gear.
Where are we going, boss?
Atlantic City. Nice flowers.
Special Agent Gibbs.
I'm Sergeant Gates, Atlantic City Police Department. You guys here to assist us?
Other way around. Here you got a dead Marine reservist. That's NCIS jurisdiction.
Works for me. This is Atlantic City. I got enough on my plate already. Happy to take second seat on this. Just make sure my office gets copies of all your findings.
Done. What do you got?
A robbery, and a big one. We got a dozen Florida retirees up for a week-long vacation. They were on the casino floor when it happened. None of them saw anything. All of them report hearing a blast and seeing everyone in the casino run for the front doors. No eyewitnesses to the actual robbery. Inside there, we have a huge mess. You might just want to go see for yourself.
Let's go.
Well, hello there, Dirty Harry. Is that a 44 Magnum?
Good eye. It was a gift from my father when I made sergeant. He was on a force as well.
Never know when you're gonna need to blow a hole in an engine block, huh?
Dinozo.
On your six, boss.
We got two dead guards. One was a Marine in the reserves. Dinozo, pictures. Don't forget the footprints. And see if Ducky or Ziva need help.
On it, boss.
Bingo. Piece of cake. I should take a photo of this. Good catch.
Thank you, Tony. Now I can get on with the rest of my work.
Look at that. Perfect. What's that over there? That's one. Keep up the good work.
A bullet went right through this cabinet. We will need to move it to get the slug.
Well, don't just stand there. Give me a hand.
Pull the cabinet, Tony. Pull. You found it. Well done, Tony.
Perfect. Yes.
Good catch.
Perfect. Perfect.
That was a tricky one. Thank you, Tony.
I should take a photo of this.
Your photographs may never make the homepage of a medical journal, but I dare say you have done splendid work, Tony.
Gibbs will want photos of the victims. Piece of cake.
Ah, thank you, Tony. Just what I asked for. Now, if you would be so kind as to help me move this body, I would be most grateful. Ready, Tony? One, two, three, lift with your leg. Gently now. We're going to take him to your left. Here we go. Good. We can put him down just there and down. Thank you again, Tony. You've been quite helpful as usual. Oh, and good luck. Look at that, over there. It appears as if one of the bullets exited the body and lodged itself in the wall behind it.
Good catch. Nice work, Doc. Good catch.
Bingo. Look what eagle-eyed Danozo just found.
Some self-respect?
I set myself up for that one. No, Ziva. I found the last slug.
Good. Now help me set up these lasers so we can triangulate the bullet trajectories.
You're welcome, Ziva.
Maybe you are good at that after all.
Wouldn't you like to know?
For this to work, you need to turn off the lights. The switch is beside the security door.
Romantic lighting coming right up.
These look like fingerprints. Better take a photo.
Perfect. Well, will you look at that?
It looks like there were two shooters. Both of them were very good shots.
This guard, however, couldn't hit the broadside of a barn, and our dead Marine didn't fire a shot. Dollars to donuts, Abby confirms it.
Why do your idioms always involve food?
Because I'm usually hungry. Do I have to teach you everything?
Not everything.
What do you got, DeNozzo?
Different sets of unidentified footprints, fingerprints on the light switch, and my gut is telling me something interfered with the guard returning fire.
Nice work, DeNozzo. Now go interview the other guard.
Which guard, boss?
The one that didn't get killed.
Right, boss.
Mr. Valesco, Special Agent DeNozzo, NCIS. Need to ask you a few questions.
Sure, yeah.
You were on duty this morning when the robbery took place?
I was supposed to be.
That a yes or a no?
All right, I was late, okay? Schedule said 2 o'clock, but I wasn't here then. Car conked out, it's a piece of crap.
Any idea who would want to rob the Lucky Card Casino?
What is a casino? Anyone who likes money. But the guy who owns Casino Noir, he's got more interest than most.
I'm gonna need a name.
His name is Brian Tasca. He's been trying to buy the Lucky Card Casino for years, but the owners wouldn't sell. Word is, he was pretty pissed about it.
You were late to work, so you didn't see what happened.
Not really.
Could you be more specific?
I told you I was late. I didn't see nothing. I don't know how many there were. I don't know how they did it, okay?
Hey, those are pretty sweet boots. I have a pair just like them.
They get the job done. And they don't make my feet sweat.
They're trailsman boots, right?
Yep. I wear them every night.
Anything else you can tell me about the night of the robbery?
Like I said, man, the robbers were gone when I got here.
Okay. If you think of anything else that might help, give me a call.
Hey, boss. I just finished interviewing the casino guard, Jason Valesco.
And?
He says the owner of a rival casino, Brian Tasca, had motive to rob the Lucky Card. McGee should look this guy up.
Right.
What do you got, McGee?
The owner of Casino Noir, Brian Tasca, is currently under federal investigation for money laundering.
And?
Tasca is in a federal prison, and his assets are frozen, which makes it highly unlikely that he could have planned the heist.
So he's not our guy?
Afraid not, boss.
Okay. Get that victim profile finished.
On it.
Good work, McGee.
Tell Abby I... I'll tell her myself.
Zip it, McGee of little faith. I've not yet begun to investigate.
Hi, Abs.
Tony, what's up?
Need you to do me a favor.
A favor? All right, what do you need?
Ziva got flowers from somebody. I need you to lift the fingerprints off of it and tell me you sent them.
Tony, are you jealous? It's like you have a little crush on Ziva all of a sudden. That's too cute.
Crush? There's no crush. I don't see any crush. In fact, I'm getting nauseous just thinking about it. You gonna help me, Abs? There's a calf cow in your future if you do.
What are friends for? But it'll cost you 2 calf pals.
Thanks, Abs. I owe you one.
Actually, 2.
Right, 2.
Let's match these footprints with the soles of known shoe brands. The footprints that lead one way out of the counting room were made by Trailsman boots, the same boots Jason Valesco wears. Let's match these footprints with the soles of known shoe brands. These footprints match boots commonly found in Army Navy surplus stores. They don't match shoes from anyone we identified at our crime scene, which means they belong to our robbers. One, two, three, and lift it up. Just what we wanted. Slow and steady wins the race. Abby Shudo does it again. These fingerprints belong to Melvin Farley. The fingerprints on the light switch belong to Jason Valesco. The fingerprints on the light switch belong to Jason Valesco.
What do you make of all this, Abby?
There's a lot here, Gibbs. It's not like I can just wave my hands over the pile and suddenly divine who your criminal is.
All right. Put it on the deduction board.
Let's see what we can find.
Why don't you explain it to me, Abs?
Just what I thought.
What does that mean, Abs?
I deserve a cupcake for that.
Why don't you explain it to me, Abs?
Okay, check this out. Gibbs, it's the other guard. Jason Valesco is the insider.
Yep.
What are you gonna do? Ooh, he did it again.
McGee, need an address for Jason Valesco.
Boss, that was the Lucky Card Casino. Valesco didn't show up for work this morning. They've called his home and his cell. No answer.
Bolo, now. McGee, trace his cell.
Already on it, boss.